presentation is about program evaluation, where a program refers to a particular intervention intended to improve the context, processes, or outcomes of people's lives. The presentation is focused on different genres or approaches to evaluation illustrated through a particular example. When I'm talking about program evaluation, I'm referring to all sectors of societies, public, private, and nonprofit. And the aim of this presentation is to illustrate three of the most common and popular genres of evaluation as a window on contemporary evaluation practice, and again, illustrate them through a particular hypothetical example. Very briefly, it's important to understand that evaluation as a professional social practice is a relatively new phenomenon, having been developed quite rapidly over the last 60, 70 years, particularly in the West, but now as an international phenomenon. International evaluation is major big business, and many, many people are participating in working on that. The various genres of evaluation, three of which again will be illustrated in this presentation, do reflect evolving and expanding ideas about evaluation's role in society, and particular questions about particular audiences and purposes for evaluation. Over time, the audiences have become expanded from a narrow interest first on policymakers to broader interest at this time in multiple kinds of stakeholders. These are five major genres or approaches to evaluation that have been developed over this 60-70 time period. I'm going to illustrate these three that are highlighted: policy-oriented, evaluation for learning and use, and democratic evaluation, through a hypothetical example. For each genre, I will address these kinds of questions, illustrate how they show up in that particular example: purpose and audience, questions, criteria for judging quality, design and methods, and the values that get advanced in that particular design. Evaluation is the process of coming to make value judgments about quality, so values are a primary part of the evaluation practice. The program to be evaluated, called the evaluand in evaluation lingo, is a hypothetical program called Food for All. This is a national U.S. program that aspires to help the most food-needy communities in the country have regular access to healthy and affordable food. These include poor urban centers, lands of some American Indian tribes, and the rural Appalachia in the central eastern part of the country. Food for All is a program that fully cooperates with the nation's proud and wonderful existing network of food banks. It is funded in part by government grants, grants from philanthropy, and citizen fundraising. It's actually been around for quite some time, so it's a mature program. It has stability of form and functioning. It's no longer in the pilot phases. It's ready to be disseminated widely. And the evaluation, the purpose of the evaluation is to guide future programming, not necessarily to test or revise the program, but to guide future targeted programming. So the first genre I'm going to illustrate is a policy-oriented evaluation. Purpose of a policy-oriented evaluation is to fulfill, to test whether a particular policy intent is being enacted as intended for an audience of policymakers. Typically, policymakers want to know, is the program reaching its outcomes? And sure enough, that's what this policy-oriented evaluation wants to know. To what extent is Food for All effective in providing food to the neediest families? So the quality criteria, the criteria by which this program will be judged in a policy evaluation, is the attainment of intended program objectives, which indeed is needy people have adequate food. The methodology for this evaluation is often or almost always an experimental evaluation. That is the right method to answer the outcome question of, did this program cause these outcomes? So an experimental methodology answers that question the best. And the values that get promoted in a policy-oriented evaluation are average effects. On the average, did the program reach its intended outcomes, the technical competence of running an experiment well, and an advancement of the existing power system. An example is an example of an evaluation of the Food for All program through a genre that's called evaluation for learning and use. All evaluators want to be useful, so let's put the emphasis on learning. And this, in this evaluation, a common purpose for an evaluation for learning would be to assess the appropriateness of the underlying program theory or logic of design for varied contexts, because the program gets disseminated to varied contexts, and not all contexts may the program theory or design work as intended. The audience for this evaluation would clearly be the developers and leadership of the program and the staff who implement it. So the kind of question that might be asked in an evaluation for learning is, how well does the logic underlying food for all work in varied contexts? It works in the ones it works in the ones that have been tested so far, but does it continue to work as we expand to new and new different programs? So a quality criterion for this evaluation would be that the program design and logic is indeed sufficiently robust, that it works in lots of different kinds of contexts to successfully provide food to the neediest people in that context. The methodology for this kind of evaluation is most likely a mixed methodology, not one particular tradition of method, but a mixed methodology, perhaps using program data, so a demographic portrait of who is being served, as well as mini case studies of some client experiences in varied contexts. So got to get the big picture as well as the micro picture in context of how this program matters and shows up in people's lives. The values that are advanced in this kind of evaluation are learning, helping to progress and being more thoughtful in learning about the character of the program and its implementation. A valuing of practice over theory. The program is established and does have a design, but it might not translate fully well to each new context. And the idea of service to all. The intention of this evaluation is to help the program make adaptations to new and different contexts as it gets disseminated. Finally, the third evaluation approach I'd like to illustrate is a democratic approach to evaluation. The purpose of this approach is indeed to foster and promote democratic values that are captured in the purpose and audience for the evaluation, as in questions like assess how well all clients, especially those who are least well served in a particular context, are equitably served by the program. And an audience for a democratic evaluation typically includes all stakeholders, including intended beneficiaries or clients of a program. The question that might be asked in a democratic evaluation, this is one of my favorite democratic evaluation questions: how well does a program like Food for All show up in people's lives? Rather than, how well do people perform in the program? It places the person's life as the context and the program as something that needs to show up in a meaningful way. It's a reversal of figure and ground, and I like that very much. And the quality criteria by which Food for All would be judged in a democratic evaluation would be that the program does indeed offer equity in access, experience, and outcomes or accomplishment for all the clients that are served. Methodology in a democratic evaluation may well be a mixed methodology, including data on clients plus some case studies. Again, like the evaluation for learning, methodology is in service to the substantive agenda. This is not an evaluation approach that's led by its methods. And the values are those of democratic equity, voice, and fairness. So in summary, evaluation is indeed the social practice of valuing. Contemporary evaluation can be responsible to varied legitimate stakeholder questions and accompanying value stances through the different kinds of genres that we have. Different genres, different approaches to evaluation address different stakeholder needs and questions differentially well. Even so, it's the evaluator's responsibility, in part, to design and implement a socially responsible study that engages and respects multiple stakeholder questions, concerns, and values.